Hello, my name is Shivani and I'm the Information and Advice Manager here at Age UK Trafford. Some of you may know that this week is Carers Week, so we thought it'd be a good idea to talk to you a little bit about being a carer and the support available to you. In particular, carer's allowance. You may not think of yourself as being a carer, but if you look after someone who would find it difficult to manage without your support, then you are a carer. Carer's allowance is paid to people who are over the age of 16, not in full-time education, and spend at least 35 hours per week providing care for someone who is ill or has a disability. The 35 hours can include time spent keeping an eye on somebody, making sure that they're safe, well, and that they take the medication. It can also include physically helping somebody, for example, helping them wash, bathe, dress and undress. It can also include practical tasks such as shopping, cooking and cleaning. You don't have to be related to the person or live with the person you care for in order to qualify. However, the person that you care for must receive a relevant disability benefit. These benefits include attendance allowance at any rate, the care component of DLA at higher or middle rate, the care component of PIP at any rate. You can be in or out of work, but you must not earn more than £128 per week. Carer's allowance is paid at the rate of £67.25 per week. So what happens if you receive a state pension? If you receive a state pension that is less than £67.25 a week, then you can claim carer's allowance. Your pension will be topped up then to £67.25 per week. If your pension is over this amount, you will not be paid carer's allowance, but you can potentially get a carer's premium or addition included on your means tested benefits. By means tested benefits, I mean things like pension credit, housing benefit. If you're of working age, benefits may include income support, income based ESA or JSA. Therefore, it's always worth coming in to get a benefits check or have a chat to see what your entitlement might be. When making an application for carer's allowance, the person you care for needs to agree to the claim. This is important as the claim for carer's allowance may affect their benefits. For example, if they receive a severe disability premium or addition on one of their benefits, then your claim for carer's allowance will stop this extra money they receive. The rules surrounding this can be complicated. Therefore, again, it's always worth coming in to get a benefits check to have a chat through what your options are. So, how do you apply for carer's allowance? Well, you can download the form from the internet, or you can make a claim online from the government website. Or you can order a paper form from the Carers Allowance Unit by contacting them on 0800 731 0298. That's 0800 731 0298. So what do you do if you make a claim and it's turned down? Well, you should ask for help as soon as possible, as you only have 1 month to challenge the decision. There's lots of other issues surrounding carer's allowance, and you can find out more information from one of our fact sheets or one of our information guides. Of course, you can always contact us, our information and advice, for free, confidential and impartial advice on 0161 746 3940. That's 0161 746 3940. I hope to see you soon.